it's a high silhouette. So if you don't like it, just go boo, and then I'll stop. We'll do something else, you know. So what we're going to start with is two very nice silver rules. And it's called the wrist and the wing. Okay, and this would be similar to a solo wrist, you know. One, I do the wrist, right? But this is going to be waltz. So we're going to do a wrist and a wing. The first step is the wrist. We both whisk, both of us. One, two, three, that's the whisk. Okay? And we're going to have to begin with it. Not over here, not over there. And we're not going this way or that way, we're going this way. Around the room, we start the diagonal walk. That's the rule. Okay? So this is diagonal walk, right? Good way to start any dance. So we start with the wrist. One, two, three. Okay? And then she's going to do a wing. She's just going to take three steps in front of me so I can do a left turn. Okay? She's going to go two, two, three. And then three. Okay, here we go. And one, two, three, two, two. Three, two, three, and then a left turn. Can we get that far? Okay. Now, if you notice, this is very important, okay? It's not so much what you do as it is how you do what you do, okay? And especially in the waltz, because it's the hardest dance there is to learn. Okay? So, the man starts out diagonal wall, and the lady starts out back in diagonal wall, it's going to go real well around the room. It's going to go down like a dance. And so, if you notice, I'm still diagonal wall, and as she comes here, I start my left turn in the line of dance, okay? Sort of wandering in the middle of the room. Honestly, the best dancers dance around the room. Okay, so it's going to look like this. We're going to left turn. We're going to do a whisk and a wing. And a left turn and a complete left turn. There it is. We can just get that far. You know, it's a good phrase, good line dance. So important. Now, any questions?
You stop before you do the wing, you pause?
I stop, absolutely. That's a good question. Listen, when you do the waltz, you go down, up, up, and you hold this for just a little bit before you come back down. And then she goes up, up again. And then you go down, up, up. But it's not way down. It's just down with your legs. And you almost come to the heel. And then you go up, up. Okay? So there's one down and two ups. That's a very good question. And you hold on the second up. Down, up, hold. Down, up, hold. Down, up, hold. Down, up, hold. Until you finish your turn. Do a little break. Get up if you stay up. Here's the good news. I'm going to let you talk. Since I was asked a question by a doctor, okay, I want you all to know this because he's a doctor, he reminds me of what it took to get my highest degree in dance teaching. Okay. We talk about these things in when we go for our master's and our grandmaster degrees. We talk about this process. When we go stretching up like this, what's happening? On the whole position, what's happening? Bless his hand. And what does the blood do? It makes those joints healthy. It prevents atrophy, and should be, okay? This is where dancing can really, really help. Or it can kill you, especially if you dance like this. Okay, I used to dance like that 40 years ago. Yeah.
But it looks like it's good timing.
Well, yes. Yes. However, it's also a good formula for a wheelchair and atrophy. First comes the atrophy, then the bursitis, then the arthritis, then the wheelchair.
We don't want that.
Okay. I'm 74 years old. I admit it, not at all then. Okay. But I've always learned to dance like this, so everything stretches and is fed with your body's fluid, the blood that makes everything healthy. Okay. You know? Okay.
What I meant to say is that you usually count the balls in 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
Yes.
But you could also, in your mind, count in 1, 2, pause, 1, 2, pause. And the third question is about
hold. Soon as we show you this again. Okay. So, it's with wing left turn. You notice I stepped between her feet and gentlemen, and I step back with my right foot to finish the left turn. Okay? All right. Let's all get a marker and get in a circle. Let's take a circle. Six couples, seven, that's 14 people. That's plenty of room. Okay, so we're going to start with the whisk and the wing. Let's just do that. Okay, ready? Begin. One, two, three. Now the wing. Two, three. Okay, now then you shouldn't move. You should be right here facing where I'm facing. Right. The man should not go around the woman. The woman should be led by the man around the hip. So let's do this one more time. So those of you who are sure, just watch me. You don't have to do anything, just watch me. Okay? So I'm facing back in the wall. I'm still facing back in the wall. First step. I'm still facing back in the wall. Second step. I'm still facing diagonal wall on the third step. Now I'm positioned to really get for a very nice looking wing. One, two, I went like this. I can step down to my right just a little bit. One, two, all things like that. That's it. But I didn't step around. I just stayed where I was. It's amazing what you can do when you stay where you are. Yeah. So let's all watch you one more time. I want the men to know because they have to leave this. Okay. So I am not going to move, I'm always going to be facing this way no matter what she does. So watch what happens here. I'm going to turn my torso a little bit like that, the whisk. I'm still facing this way. You see? Now watch this. I'm going to step down on this right foot just a little bit and put my left foot over here while she takes three steps. Now my left foot's free to go right between her feet and she goes right between me as I step back on my left. Okay? Okay, so we're going to show these people over here. Susan? Yeah, just like you started. Yeah. goes between your feet and finish it there. He goes on the first three steps, he goes one, two, three, and then he holds.